What's up, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about installing and configuring pfSense 2.4.5 on Windows Server 2019 Hyper-V. So let's get into it. All right, so on my desktop, I'm going to right-click on my start menu, go to run, type in WinVer, hit OK, and I'm running everything within a Server 2019 build 17783. Now I'm going to click on my start menu, and within my start menu, I'm going to go inside Windows Administrative Tools, locate Hyper-V Manager, and then click on it to load it up. Now the first thing that I need to do within Hyper-V is click on the Virtual Switch Manager. And I need to create a new virtual switch. So I'm going to pick internal and then click on the button that says create virtual switch. And then I'm going to provide it a name, apply it, and then I'm good to go. Now I'm going to open up my favorite browser, which is Chrome. And I'm going to search for pfSense, hit enter. And I'm going to click on the download link. It's going to take me here. For the architectural, I'm going to click on the drop down menu and then pick AMD 64. And for the installer, I'm going to pick CD image ISO and then click on download. It's going to start downloading the ISO file. Once it's done, click on the little arrow, show in folder, and it's going to open up. Now this file has an extension of .gz, so I need to extract it. So I'm going to right click on it, go to 7-zip, and I'm going to pick extract here. It's going to extract it and then bam. Now the one with the GZ extension, I'm going to select it, right click on it and then delete it. So I only have the ISO file. Let's go back inside Hyper-V Manager and on the node, let's right click on it, go to new virtual machine. You're going to get the new virtual machine wizard. Click on next, provide it a name, a location, specify the generation, Gen 1 or Gen 2, then click on next, assign it some memory and then click next. Connect it to a network. From here, create a virtual hard disk and give it a size and then click on next. And with the installation options, I'm going to pick install an operating system from a CD or DVD ROM and then pick image files and then click on browse and then pick your pfSense ISO file. And then there you go and click next. And it gives you a nice little summary and then click on finish. It's going to start creating the disk for you and then you're done. Now select your virtual machine, right click on it, hit connect, go to file, settings, and within here we want to add a new network adapter. So select network adapter, click on add. From here we want to click on the virtual switch drop down menu and then click our new virtual switch that we created. For me it was btnhd-net, apply it, okay it, and you're good to go. Now within the virtual machine, click on start to boot it up. It's going to start loading up and then take you here. You're going to hit enter to accept. Hit OK to start the installation. You're going to pick your key map selection, then hit enter. I'm going to do the auto guided disk setup. So hit enter here. It's going to start processing itself. You're going to get this. The installation is now finished. You are able to get into a shell prompt. I'm going to hit no, hit enter, and it's going to want to reboot. If you hit reboot, what's going to happen? It's going to reboot itself. It's going to do this and it's going to bring you back to the installation. So within Hyper-V, I'm going to click on action and then turn off and then click on turn off. It's going to shut down the machine. And then from here, click on media, DVD drive, and then just remove the ISO and then click on start for it to boot up. Once you boot up, it's going to ask you a question. Should VLANs be set up now? I enter N for no, hit enter. It's going to want you to enter the WAM interface. I have HN0 and HN1. So HN0 is actually my NAT switch, which I actually have to assign a static IP address. And HN1 is the switch, the network switch that we created together. Now for the WAM, it's going to be HN0, hit enter. And for the LAN, it's going to be HN1, and you can hit enter. And then you're going to see right now that the WAM is assigned to HN0. And the LAN is assigned to HN1. Do you want to proceed? I'm going to hit Y for yes. And it's going to start configuring the interfaces and then bam. Now automatically the LAN is already set with an IP address, which I want to change. Now the WAM is not assigned to an IP address. And the reason why is because within my environment, I assign the WAM to a NAT switch. So I have to assign an IP address for it to talk to outside, right? So I'm going to pick 2. And from here, I'm going to pick 1 because that's the WAM and that's what we want to configure. And it's going to say configure the IPv4 address WAM interface via DHCP. I don't want to use DHCP, so I'm going to hit N. And then it's going to want me to enter the WAM v4, and I'm going to enter my IP address. It's going to want me to enter my subnet mask, so it's 24. Then I need to enter my gateway. So I enter my gateway, hit enter. And then do you want to configure the v6 address WAM? I think I hit Y for yes, hit enter. Do you want to revert to HTTP? This is a testing lab, so I hit Y, hit enter, and it's going to start configuring itself. Give you a nice little summary, hit enter, and then bam, my WAM now has an IP address, right? Now, I need to change my LAN. So the LAN is the same approach. You hit 2, follow the prompts. The only difference is between your WAM is that you're assigning a starting and the ending for your address pool. At the end of it, I assigned my LAN to 10.10.10.2, okay? With a subnet of 24. Just follow the prompts. Just hit 2, hit enter, just read the prompts and just set it up for your environment, right? I didn't want a 192.168.1.1, right, for my environment. I wanted something else. I found a virtual machine within my environment. I went inside the settings, and within the network adapter, I made sure that it was set to btnhd.net, and I started up the machine. I opened up a browser, and I went to 10.10.10.2. And it's going to load up the pfSense web interface. Now, by default, the admin and password is admin, and the password is pfSense. So once you sign in, you're going to get the wizard. Just follow the wizard. From here, I clicked on next. Next again. General information. Make sure you give it a primary DNS server as well as a secondary DNS server. And then once you enter all that information, click on next. Configure your time server information. Once you're done with that, click on next. For the WAM, I don't really need to do anything because, again, I configured a static IP address, which was great. I would say go over all the configurations for your WAM interface and modify it within your environment. Once you're done, go all the way to the bottom and then click on next. Configure your LAN interface. We did that within the command shell. But if you need to change it here. Click on next. This is where you need to change that password, which is pfSense, the default one. Change it to something else, something stronger. And then once you're done, click on next, reload. It's going to start reloading itself and then take you here. Check for updates. Click on the check for updates. And it's going to check for updates to make sure that you're running the latest update. If not, just push out the latest update before continuing. From here, I'm going to click on the pfSense little icon logo. And it's going to take me to the home page, the dashboard. And it's going to prompt you this. Just hit accept. And it's going to thank you. Just click on close. Now, one of the things that I noticed within pfSense is that the DNS server is automatically pointing to a loop. I don't want that. So to change that, I'm going to go inside systems, general setup. And I'm going to go to the bottom where it says disable DNS forwarder. So I'm going to give it a check mark. Go all the way to the bottom. Hit save. And then when you go back inside the dashboard, you're going to see that loopback is gone. Now, next thing that I need to configure is my DNS for my DHCP server for my LAN. So at the top, click on services, locate DHCP server. It's going to take you directly to your LAN. And within LAN, go all the way to the bottom where you see servers, DNS server. So provide your DNS server. So I provided, you know, Google's DNS servers. And then I went to the bottom. Once you're done providing your DNS server, click on save. And then it's going to say the changes have been applied successfully. Within command prompt, I did an ipconfig/all. And it gave me my 10.10.10.11, which is the subnet that I provided for my LAN. Now, I did a ping to Google, and everything is pinging out. I'm able to talk to the outside world, and that's awesome. And that's it, guys. That is how we configure pfSense 2.4.5 within Hyper-V Server 2019. Make sure to hit that like button. Also, do not forget about punching, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.